When you hear Russia, you think many things. Some people think communism, other people think the hammer and sickle, and others think the Soviet Union. But what a lot of people don't think is the czars of Russia. And when I started reading on them, I realized that there's more to Russia than they've let on. Messenger. Our kingdom is falling apart. And I know why. We don't have a strong leader to save us from this downward spiral.
My lord, why don't we send out a call to those who are qualified to lead our nation, and the people can vote on the leaders that they want?
That's a great idea, Gennady. Send out the call.
My lord.
What news do you have, Gennady?
We have collected the nominations and voted on them, and the people have chosen young Michael Romanov. He has a strong lineage and strong ideals, and he is perfect to save our country.
If that is what the people want, then fetch him. My mind's telling me no. But my body's telling me yes.
I'm searching for Michael Romanov. It is said that he should be here at this monastery.
You found me. What is it that you want?
You have been chosen to be new Tsar of Russia, and it is a great and honorable task.
I can't rule Russia. I'm just a boy.
If Josiah ruled Israel at 8, you can rule Russia at 16. Don't you want to save your country?
Michael, as your mother, I think this is a great opportunity that the Lord has granted you. Don't let it go to waste.
Well, I do love Russia. I just want you to know that I'm doing this for Russia, not for you guys.
That's all I wanted to hear.
I hereby anoint you Tsar of Russia. Lead our country well. Young Michael Romanov!
Michael did lead his country well. He ended Russia's wars with Sweden and Poland, and he brought Russia out of its depression that it was trapped in. When he passed away, he left the throne to his son, Alexei, but that's not the emperor that we're going to talk about today. No, our Tsar is much more great. Next, we will be showing you tapes that we unearthed in Russia's Grand Library. They are of a therapy session between one of Peter's advisors and him towards the end of his life. The following content is very disturbing, and viewer discretion is advised for our younger viewers. Why are you crying, Peter?
Because I'm a freak.
How are you a freak?
Because I killed innocent people and I call myself great.
That is pretty messed up, but why else are you a freak?
Because I'm freakishly tall and I took advantage of my mentally deficient brother, Ivan.
Wow, okay. What's your occupation again?
I'm Tsar of Russia.
Okay, I think that this problem has to do with your childhood. Can you tell me a bit about that?
Well, I was born into political uproar, and I witnessed many murders and assassinations, some of which led to me and my brother Ivan becoming co-Tsars of Russia.
Okay. So, Peter, tell me about your love.
I have 2 wives and 14 children.
Wow, this guy's busy. Okay, so what happened to those children?
Only 3 of them survived until adulthood.
You're saying that pretty matter-of-factly. Like, what's up with that?
Well, that's what happens when you grow up in the political world.
Okay. So, speaking of love life, how about we bring in Catherine?
Hi, Peter!
No! No, please, God, no!
Thank you for watching our show. Please join us next week when we will be discussing who wore it best at the Oscars.
Hey girl. Oh now. You know you got everybody looking. Got a little bit. boom in my big truck. Gonna open up the doors and turn it up. Gonna stomp my boots in the Georgia mud. Gonna watch you make me fall in love. Get up on the hood of my daddy's tractor. Up on the toolbox, it don't matter. Down on the tailgate, girl, I can't wait to watch you do your thing. Shake it for the young bucks sitting in the honky tonks. For the rednecks rocking to the break.